Well, is it not gonna finish loading here? Looks like that crash may have broke my game. I'll just force it closed real quick. We'll try one more time. And if that doesn't work, I'll just go in and start another save. Definitely looks like it's loading up faster than it was earlier. So hopefully it's gonna work this time. Gotta love technical difficulties. And this is where it's stuck. I'm not waiting. I'll just start another play on that. We weren't too far along, so shouldn't take too long to get back where it was. A few things on here I don't want. Most of these are fine. I'm looking for manual attach. I don't want to mess with that. Alright, let's see. Oh, the mixing tools. Okay, let's get rid of that then. I do not want to deal with Maze Plus right now. Good to me. I'm not worried about what the guy looks like. Oh wow. Reset everything on my game. Stone, but I do like that plowing on them. And then we will get rid of all of the... Okay. And save. Assuming we still have all the same fields. Yes. First things I want to check out is to see if it was just me having Maze Plus on earlier that caused the way that feeding the animals was. Because they were requiring a lot of food. See what state this puts the grass in when we pick it up. Normally I wouldn't want to mow the cow pasture, but because I do have, pretty sure I have the animal feeding mod or grazing mod on so that they will automatically get something from the grass in the pasture. But since I don't have any cows in here, this is perfectly fine to go ahead and mow. And see what it looks like when it's done. Hopefully I can get some silage started. Get cows if this can be picked and put in the silage clamp, then I'll definitely be getting cows soon. And when we harvest the wheat fields, we'll get some chickens again. Wasn't planning on starting all over on a map this quick, but I guess sometimes you have to. Tell that the music is playing right now, though. Yes. Thank you. Yeah. Okay. I think I'm going to adjust just a little. Definitely looks more like normal cut grass than the last time I mowed, so not sure if we'll get back to where we were before, but I'll definitely try to get back to that point again. I'm a little more familiar with some pieces, so hopefully it'll be faster to get to that point. What I was doing there, that was kind of a weird direction I went on there. go ahead and get this put in the silings, and then we'll mow another one in for hay. Underpowered this belt for these corners. Go over here into this field behind the house. Not sure how to get into it yet, but we'll figure that out. There's a wheat field just down there, and so there's three wheat fields ready to harvest right now. On the map. That's where the chickens are. There's not a way into that field here. Seems like a relatively flat field, so hopefully this tractor doesn't have too many issues with it. I think we can definitely afford to get rid of one or two of the tractors that we have, so and pick up something with a little more horsepower than this one has. Definitely not hurt us any. That was one of my first goals in the last playthrough on this map. Replacing this tractor. Or not this one, but some of the smaller ones so that more large tractors. Might even be able to do that right off the bat here. Don't know how much a couple of the ones we have are worth, but see if they'll give us enough. Well, I was planning on streaming for another hour only, but since there was such a pause in the middle there, I may have to go just a little bit longer tonight. We'll see how far progression is when I hit another or an hour from now. Probably check and see which one of these fields is bigger and we'll do the biggest one for silage. That's the best money maker if we end up selling any. And we'll do the smallest one for hay. Then we can get the straw from the wheat and that'll be everything we need for TMR for the cows. Definitely say the starting setup on this map is pretty nice. Can't say that you can, I've ever actually been able to do everything I need in the first day with what is provided on a map and have TMR basically available. Thanks for the follow, Mr. Starbucks Man. How are you doing today? Everybody watching how many or how long has everyone played Farm Sim? If you do play, what's your favorite map? Actually kind of partial to Elm Creek on 22 right now. Shocked with it being a base game map, but that, I think that one's actually a really good one. I do not have a series on it, but I've definitely put a lot of hours into it. Usually the one I, when I make my mod shorts for YouTube, that I'm on Elm Creek when I record those. Alright. drop these off and go down. Well, before I go too far, this is field 95, 3.42 hectares, acres. Just manually open them. That's a lot easier. Watch out, doggy. Don't want to run you over. And then this field is 2.7. So we'll pull silage off the other one. And we'll make this one here hay. Park that there. This one will work for tedding. Too many sheds, and not to mention things are a little bit spread out. Need to get like equipment put together. Open, thank you. Slinging this grass. Really like the animation they've added onto this one. For 22, that looks so much better than it did in 19. It shouldn't take too long to get all the grass done and hay. At least to start, most of it, or all of it's gonna end up going into straight into the cow barn, so I won't worry too much about getting it baled up to store. Future cuts would. I'll worry about baling it and getting it put up in the barn. But since everything can go into the one, it shouldn't be an issue. It'll definitely hold it over there. Go ahead and do another lap around. I may have missed a little bit back here on that corner. I'm sure it'll be fine though. we can come back and get it on the next cut. It's one thing that I thought was really neat on with the seasons mod on Farm Sim 19. And I kind of wish they would have added on here where your grass and stuff like that, if it's out in the weather and not covered, actually rots away. So you can't just leave it out in the field. If it rains, it'll start to deteriorate. So I can understand somewhat not making it permanent fixture in the game, but just like season on here, you can turn that off, so it, ideally it would just be something you can toggle on and off. Crazy. I think I might get rid of this tractor and the burr or whatever it's called. See if that'll get us enough to purchase something a little bit larger than the voucher. I like this little tractor, but we also have a, I think it's a Massey with a front loader, so that's definitely the one that, because it's got the front loader and everything, is the one worth keeping. And I think it's a little bit bigger than this one. Just do a donut here. Swinging hay everywhere. One passes and this will be done. Go grab the rake and finish it all up. Sometimes it looks like this thing turns when you turn. It doesn't actually just follow, like just turning the wheel without the tractor even moving, it starts wiggling around. Let's do that. There we go. Put that down, drive over here. Definitely way more effective that way. So we will fit the tether in here, I think. gonna get all of our bailing type equipment in one spot. Just barely clipped that. So once we get the breakout, that'll be easier to get to. Might as well start with this one as it's the closest. I was going to switch over to that, switch tractors, but the one I think it's a Massey, but we'll grab that one when it comes time to using the forage wagon and picking everything up. This one's got plenty hours on it, so it's not like we're going to really depreciate it too much. 257 hours already. So if we sell it, I'm not going to lose that much money. Which actually, that might be why the voucher seems to have so little power. I might just need to repair it. One here, actually all the tractors, I haven't really looked at that on them until this one here, so going through and repairing the tractors might help us out a lot. Do that, I might not even feel the need to upgrade yet. Shop on this already placed, or I need to add one in. Turn around there, but it worked. How's everybody doing today? thing with the windrower having the steering like it does, it definitely makes it turn real quiet, real tight. Almost through this field. That little bit we can come back for. That's not too bad. The field is just over here. Thank you. see. Try that again. Hit the button to fold it up instead of the lower it. This field is a little bit larger, but it's also longer and skinny, so I don't think it'll take any more time than the other one did to get it all windrowed. Could do a better job of actually grabbing a full pass here. Definitely skimping on one side. Actually, it looks like when my computer crashed earlier, it reset the UI on the game and everything. I had set a lot smaller than all this. I'll have to fix that. That outside of the game, though. I don't think it can do it in the graphics in here. HUD, that's not UI. I mean, I guess same thing. I don't know why, when I was at the other end, I did not pick up the windrower. I was gonna make that a little bit fun to try and turn that corner and get that a little bit. How's everyone doing? I'll get this done though. Definitely gonna go ahead and buy some cows as soon as we get all this picked up. I'm gonna be able to get it all. Try to be as wide as possible here. On the last pass, I've only got to make one pass. Yeah, that makes perfect sense. Obviously, if it's the last one, it's only one. Yeah, so there is only one more pass after that one. That's what I meant to say. Looks like it will be. And I can start picking it all up. And that does it. Shut it off. Hold it up. Oh, sorry about that. Bring it back over here. It was over here, and that is a good spot for it. That's where the rest of our grass baling equipment is. And I'm going to switch over. Yep. Was a mess, Ferguson. Oh, I did not need to wait. We'll go ahead and take the pull the weight out of here. I'll set it over off to the side. like to have it available. And I won't be putting this tractor back in there probably. So. For the time being, I'll set it right here. Pop that much over there. Oh, we have the stone picker over there too. We can sell that. Baler and a trailer. Planter, roller, and looks like. Oh no. That a roller planter combo? I don't know. It's a weeder. We'll definitely sell off that stone picker since stones are turned off. Not here. Nothing over there. They had to have been over here. One of these. Nothing. Yep, it was right beside this tractor. Way to have my eyes open. Everything off this field will go over into a silage clamp. And be turned into silage. Most likely just for feeding the cows. Usually like to keep it all until the next cut comes up, just in case I need more. I don't know if I'll transfer it all over to the cow barn right away, but we'll at least keep it in the clamp. This tractor only has 42 hours on it, but it's still halfway down on the service, so it needs repaired. Raise that front loader arm up. We'll see if that's high enough, but it'll still trigger the gate over here, so I don't have to get out and open it every single time. Does it work? There we go. Just a little bit lower. I'm gonna cut through here. No. That should be for manure. Guess in the dry storage for potatoes or beetroot, something like that. and apparently put grass in there. Don't know that that's really what I want to do. Unless there's something that'll automatically ferment or make. Yeah, I might look at that. See if they start us out with a ferment or make protection. Nope. Okay, so it's literally just storage. Oh. I guess you can't drive into the side of the building and expect them to be able to move. No? Is this a... Turn on, lower. Lower here. Can I not put grass? Manure heat, fertilize, bale and pallet storage, house, chickens, bunker silo large. I'm just going to sell it and replace it and see if that works. Silo. Not that big. Nothing really. So stick out way too far. Something smaller. Again, that's a minor heat. Come on. Put a little bale thing in there. Looks like we can make it faster to go through there, but be nice to have thought that that's the one that was there, but it's not. 12 by 28, but that looks larger than the one that said like 9 by 39. Taking way too long. If I can twist that at an angle, that'd be perfect. But it won't. It's a 90 degree only. Gonna stick through the bushes a little bit. It'll be alright. Go ahead. Well, that made us a lot of money. Not intentionally, but I thought I was gonna be able to replace the one that I took out of there. Thought I'd try that, see if it was actually one that we could put it in, but it is not. Kind of looks like it by the design, but nonetheless. Hopefully this works now that I think that time. No. So I don't. So I just need to force it. Yes. Oh well. Guess we got more money out of it. That's something. All right. Probably gonna find that annoying the way it's placed, and want to replace a new one in later, somewhere else. I can cut through back there if I remember. It may be too tight though for the turning radius on the tractor with this. Watch out, doggy. I hope the silo clamp we just put in will hold all of this. I don't know if it said, but I did not look to see how much it held. If not, I guess we can go through. Actually, I'll probably just pick it all up and maybe we'll buy some sheep instead if we've got leftover grass. That will be a use for it. I won't necessarily say a good one, but sheep definitely seem like a slow option starting out if you don't have the spinnery and stuff to actually process the wool. But money is money at the beginning. Just need to be working along, making as much of it as we can. Oh, so close. We'll just skim across here and hopefully be full. There it is. I'm beginning to wonder if that was actually going to fill up from that little bit. If we're still good to, yes, that actually works with the forks on this. There's fuel. That fuel tank's kind of in a really bad spot. I'm not sure that it'll be so easy to get some of the equipment, especially if you can get bigger equipment in there. We'll find out when that time comes, though, I guess. How's everyone doing out there watching? How's your day? Pretty good? Mine felt like a very long day. Stuck. Yeah, that was horrible. Way too tight. I have to try not to get up on that wall next time. Makes it harder to get out of there. Open sesame. For those just joining, we're picking up the grass right now to put in the silage clamp so that we can make a little progress toward getting some cows. I'd like to, before the stream's over, have at least a few head of cow. I don't know if we'll buy adult or buy young and let them grow. I'll probably go ahead and get full and mature ones, that way they can start breeding right off the bat. I've not looked to see if our cow barns actually have to have water attached to them or if they are already plumbed in. But we have to have silage, hay, straw, all that first before we can even worry about any of that, so. Get all the buildup done and does not look like I'm gonna finish this row. Yep, definitely gonna be full before we get this one done. Looks like we got a few loads. We're gonna get like 5 or 6 loads out of this field. That's really not too bad. Oh yeah, I think we'll be able to fit all of this in here just fine. Oh. Watch where your forks are. Next load, I'll drive up, start driving up on top of the pile so we can start working on the compaction while we're unloading too. Because we definitely, everybody that's played this knows, if you've done silage, compacting has got to be the most exciting part of it all. Down here, I'll grab this a little bit. Oh, I forgot to add. Done a U-turn with the windrower down earlier. I still think that'll definitely be fun to pick up. Definitely a lot harder to make those corners with the forage wagon and keep it on the row. Alrighty, got another load. I think the wheel loader will be the best one to compact this with. Definitely the heaviest piece of equipment that it will be capable of climbing up over this. I'm sure that the combine's heavier, but don't know that that'll work too well to compact silage. Could be interesting. Destroy that barn. I'm gonna knock it down anyway with this tractor. Definitely in a bad spot. For me, anyway. I will say, the European maps, they definitely utilize all the space. Americans are a lot more wasteful when it comes to that. We have huge wide open lots that you spin circles around in the yard with the equipment, and you're fighting for space on the European maps. Two more rows. And this is done. See if I can do the U-turn. And I can't believe I did that without missing any. Looks like I come back for one partial load back there. For this row. It'll probably be about 2/3 of a load. make it. Ramming speed. There we go. As long as I don't move too far back, I don't want to be in the bushes back there. Last strip. Looks like when I turn around, I'm going to be picking up a little bit more there. Since I decided to just skip right over the top of that. Sure, I just drove around it, but... Alright. That's all the grass picked up for... The silage, 51%. That's not bad. I haven't looked, we'll have to see, get a total of exactly what's in the pit before we finish off here. Be about 90,000. That'll definitely get us pretty far with some cows. It's empty, but it... not have that. Put this over here for now. And I don't know that I will fully compact, but we will at least get started on it. We could also use this to level it out if we need to, but I think we will be fine on that. I think it'll be good enough. Not really much in here, so we shouldn't also have to worry about it coming out the other end of the pit. That's always good. No mess to clean up when we get done. It's not taking too long to come back either. We're already at 25%. Done this before, now you get to see how exciting it can be. Luckily I'm not getting stuck all the time. That definitely makes this job a lot worse. You're stuck on a high centered and stuff. But I'm not doing it with a tractor, so that also makes a big difference. You can do it with a wheel loader or something. Even just an articulating tractor will work pretty well too most of the time, but standard tractor like the ones we have are usually a huge pain to sit and do this with. Only 10% to go, and we can cover this thing up. Alright, and I will just park this right beside it. Looks like a good spot to me. That'll take a month in game, usually, to fully ferment. So, next task will be to pick up the hay. And we'll go ahead and get that done. I think that we'll just put all the hay in, or at least a couple loads of it in there where the cows go. Might want to go ahead and, or might need to go ahead and grab a couple cows to see how much we can fit in there and stuff. That button. Actually, before I get started on this, I want to check on something here. Guessing this should be roughly about the same at 90,000, but we should not need 90,000. liters of straw. That's a lot of straw. Or hay, at least. Not sure if this will go faster or not with the forage wagon, but I think it can. There's load number one from here. Oh, going a little too fast. Can I put this in here, or do I have to actually get cows first? We can go ahead and put some in. So which, let's see, that'll show us. No, because we don't have any animals, it will not actually show us what we just put in there. So now we got cows out of here while we try to pick stuff up, but that does mean we can come in here and look. Let's see. Apparently they have no food. It shows water, but I don't know if there's something we're going to have to do. Straw we'll get once harvest the wheat and get it all. Watch out, cow. Cows does 10 appear to be out here. 2, 3. Oh. Yeah. Pretty large cow pen, so. Oh. There's some inside too, so it looks like it's actually going to reflect how many we bought. Oh, really? Was that close to being able to get that whole line? Cows are probably just laying out there eating the hay off the ground. I mean, why do I even need to pick it up? I should put a load through there. I don't think until we have everything in here the robot will do anything. Not sure, we'll give it a little bit of time. I think it'll do it. It'll run at the top of the hour every hour. So I'll check when it hits 10 o'clock in game and see if it's giving them hay or not. I'm kind of thinking it's only going to give them the TMR mix if everything's there though. Which means it'll be next in-game day before they will be able to get the silage moved over to it. No more than two left out here. It doesn't show what's in here either, does it? Does not show that there's anything inside this. Ah. That way does. So 48,000 in there right now. Okay. That cow just laid down, but I'm gonna pick up his bed that I missed. Sorry, Mr. Cow. Can't sleep on that. You need it for food. Before I run down to the other end on that line. I need to figure out the water thing. I don't know why it's showing I need water. Because I was pretty sure that the buildings were supposed to automatically give water to the animals. And I know previously when I tried giving water to horses, it was not taking it. There was nowhere to put it. It said it wasn't accepted. I'm not exactly sure what's going on there. Unless they will just be the horses on that one were not automatically either at overtime. I'm not sure what to do with that yet. We'll dump this load and then I will go pick up the last of it. And that'll probably pretty well be the end of the stream. And next time we'll get the hay done so we can get straw, or the wheat done so that we can get straw over here. And then we're just waiting on the silage to ferment all the way and get that in there, which I'll need to put some straw in there for the total mixed ration, and I'll need to put some in there. Not drop. Anyway, I'll need to put some in for the total mixed ration and then some of it in for the bedding in the barn. Which I also do not know where to put that yet on this one. Usually you have to drive into the barn to do that one though. My guess is it'll pop up and tell me. $64,000 there. Shows food $5,000. What did they get? Grass. So it did grazing. Did pick up from out there. So that's good, at least. But I will go ahead and dump this little bit of grass in here, just so they have more hay in here. Just so they have a little bit better food to feed on until the everything is ready for the total mix ration. Wasn't much, but it's definitely better than the grass will be. Time back now. Fine, we should have plenty of time for today. That is going to be it for today though. We got quite a bit done. Got the silage there fermenting. Two larger fields cut, and one of them picked up for the silage, and the other one here picked and windrowed and headed and everything for hay. Got that hay put in here, some of it for total mix ration, and some of it I just dropped off for the cows to eat now. And we bought 10 cows. So we're off to a pretty good start for being forced to start over. Next time I will work on getting the 3 wheat fields cut and we'll put the wheat in silo or go ahead and pick up some chickens. And we'll give the wheat to the chickens, at least whatever they'll take. Chicken pen is over here. Coop, kind of large, call it a coop, but and I guess that's still what it is. But we'll put some chickens in there. We'll look in the water for the cows, see if there's a spot where I actually have to do that. I still think that there should be something here that automatically does that. I think that's where straw goes. Little door here, nothing in there. This is the milk. But, well, I'm sure we'll figure it out. We do already have 2 liters of milk. That's good. But I'd like to thank everyone for stopping by and joining me today. If you are still here and you haven't followed or subscribed, please do so if you liked it. Also, put down a like. Anyone that's on Kick or Twitch, I stream on YouTube, Kick, and Twitch. So if you missed part of this and want to watch on YouTube, it's also will be posted there. Thank you all again, and I will see you next time.